हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। एंड इफ़ यू फाइंड दिस वीडियो यूज़फुल फॉर यू, देन प्लीज़ लाइक, कमेंट एंड सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल। ओके, सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ डेमोक्रेटिक रिपब्लिक ऑफ कॉन्गो और DRC। वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट दिस कंट्री, व्हाट इज़ इट्स लोकेशन, व्हाट इज़ इट्स क्लाइमेट, है ना, एंड व्हाट आर द फिजिकल फीचर्स ऑफ दिस कंट्री दैट वी आर गोइंग टू रीड। ओके, सो this country was formerly known as Zaire. Its old name is Zaire and it is located in the Africa continent. Okay, it is located between 5 degree north and 10 degree south latitude. Now we have already learned in the previous videos how to identify a place on the earth. So here I have one map. It is a map of world political map. Here you can see this 0 degree latitude. This side also you can see this 0 degree. So if you draw a line from this 0 to this 0, then you will get the equator. Okay, so this is the equator or 0 degree latitude on the earth. Then here you can see this 23.5 degree north and this 23.5 degree south. Okay, now if you want to check that where is the location of this Congo, then you have to search in between this 0 degree to 5 degree north and 0 degree to 10 degree south. Okay, then if you draw these lines, then you will get that country in the center of this equator. Okay, here somewhere here it will lie. So this is the Democratic Republic of Congo in between center. It lies in the central Africa. Okay, this is Africa continent, and it lies between 5 degree north to 10 degree south. Okay, so this is the location of that country. See this central here, and here is the capital of that DRC. It is Kinshasa. What it is? Kinshasa. This is the capital of DRC. Okay, then we have the location we have seen. It is the third biggest African country. It is the third biggest African country in the in area. Means Sudan is first biggest country, then Algeria is the second biggest country, and then comes Democratic Republic of Congo, that is DRC, third biggest country in Africa. Its area is 23.5 lakh square miles. Its area means it covers this much area. Then location we have seen, it is located in the Central Africa. Equator passes through it, and here 33% of country located in the northern hemisphere and the rest falls in the southern hemisphere. Why? Because equator passes through it and equator divides this country. Okay, then it is bordered by many countries, or border means there are for these neighboring countries. Okay, so Central African Republic and South Sudan in the north, then Angola and Zambia in the south direction, Uganda, Rwanda, Tanzania, Burundi in the east, and Republic of Congo in the west. So you can see in the map also here, this is a map of Africa. Here you can see the neighboring countries. This see south, this is Angola, then Zambia, Tanzania, South Sudan, and you can say Republic of Congo. This side, Republic of Congo, and in the north you can also see Central Republic or Central African Republic, South Sudan. They are in the north. Angola and Zambia, they are in the south. Tanzania, Uganda, Rwanda, they are in the east. And Republic of Congo in the west. Okay, so these are the neighboring countries of this DRC. And the capital of DRC is Kinshasa and it lies here. Okay. So you will not see any coastal area here. That's why it is known as landlocked country. It is bordered by all the sides by land. There is no water around it. There is no sea water or ocean water around it. Okay, it has no sea coast. And this Kinshasa is located on the river, on the banks of river Congo. Which river? River Congo. Okay. Then we will see the relief features of Congo. Relief feature means what type of land is there, what are the land features are there. Okay. If you see, it is just like our India. It has three mountain ranges. It has coastal plains, high plateaus, major valley and a large river basin. Okay. Then this river Congo is very important river in the DRC, and it is most important, and it is also known as highway of Central Africa because it is the main mode of transportation in the country, and also it has economic importance, extreme economic importance. This river Congo get joined with many tributaries. Now what are tributaries? Tributaries are the small rivers that joins a big river. Okay, so these are the tributary of this main Congo river, and these tributaries are small rivers are Kasai, Sangha, then Ubangi, Aruvimi and Lulonga. These are the rivers that join this river Congo. Okay, so in this way we have seen that river Congo is very important because of its mode of transportation and economic importance. Okay, then in the eastern part of the country there are many lakes like Lake Albert, Lake Edward and Lake Kivu. Lake Albert, Lake Edward and Kivu. These are the lakes that are located in the eastern part of the country. As DRC lies in the equatorial region, it receives heavy rainfall. Where it lies? In the equatorial region. Now, what is equatorial region? You know. We have already discussed it in our previous video. Equatorial region means that lies, suppose this is Earth, and this is equator, and the region around the equator. Okay, this is called the equatorial region. Okay, this is equator. So it lies here in the equatorial region, 33% in the north and remaining in the south. Okay, south hemisphere, north hemisphere and south hemisphere. Okay, so what will be the climate at is lies in the equatorial region? We know that in equatorial region the sun rays are falling directly. Okay, direct sun rays are falling, and that's why it is very hot. And this climate of the country, it is very favorable climate for growing dense and thick forest. Okay, so and it also receives heavy rainfall throughout the year. Heavy rainfall throughout the year. So now we will read about its climate. Okay, so climate is favorable for growth of thick and dense forest, and it receives a heavy rainfall throughout the year, and there is no soil erosion or and soil is rich in humus. No soil erosion because there are dense forest, and because of this forest this soil does not get washed with water. The roots of these trees and plants, they hold the soil, roots of the plants hold the soil, and it does not get washed with the rainwater. okay, so there is no soil erosion, and soil is rich in humus. Soil is rich in humus. Okay, then it is extremely hot throughout the year without much difference in summer and winter. Means the summer and winter temperatures are near about same. There is no difference in between the temperatures of this summer and winter season. Okay, days and nights are equal length. Days and nights are of equal length as it lies in the equatorial region, because it lies in the equatorial region. Okay, then we have 4 o'clock showers. What is 4 o'clock showers? See, due to the high temperature, there is plenty of evaporation. We know that very dense forests are there. Okay, dense and thick forests are there, and we know that these trees and plants, they are continuously giving out water in the form of evaporation, in the form of water vapors. Okay, and this water vapor given out by these plants in the process of transpiration, and because of this, clouds build up. Clouds are forming on a regular basis. Because of this water vapors, clouds are forming, and it is raining every day. Near about every day in the evening, it rains. So this happens almost every evening, and this, and that's why this rainfall is known as 4 o'clock showers. 4 o'clock showers. Okay. Mornings, how are the mornings there? Mornings are pleasant with lots of sunshine. Mornings are pleasant with lots of sunshine, and evenings and nights are cool because of the heavy showers, means heavy rainfall. Okay, so here we will stop. We'll meet in our next video. Till then, take care. Goodbye.